Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm so very happy to welcome all of you to the first International Conference on Restorative Justice in Bangladesh. Before I go any further, may I request all of you to take out your mobile phones and put it off the ringer. Or as Richard often says, anybody's phone which goes off very loudly will get fined a hefty sum. In many parts of the world, there is compelling evidence that it is a victim-centered approach that brings closure for the victim and helps reduce fear in the victims. It works to repair the harm caused by crimes. It aids reintegration of the offender back into the community, and in some cases, to revert the victim back to the original situation they were in before the crime happened, thereby reducing the hurt and the emotional impact that crime may have caused. Restorative justice brings the offender and the victim together in a dialogue, helping them to understand each other's situation. Such a situation, guided by a trained mediator, often ends with an agreement between the victim and the offender on compensation or restitution. This is known as crime with being instead punished. And the large amount of money that the traditional criminal justice system would have taken out. Some of the issues and problems that impact on safety, justice, and the criminal justice system. Our prisons are overcrowded. Our courts are and the poorest people are often not able to afford the cost associated with taking a case through the formal criminal justice system. These are only some of the problems that threaten access to justice for many people living in Bangladesh. This conference marks the beginning of a promising dialogue between policymakers and professionals working in the criminal justice system and how the aforementioned and other relevant issues can be tackled with restorative justice. The genesis of this conference is a result from the ongoing discussion between the two ministries, Home and Law, on the importance of restorative justice for tackling the pressure of outstanding cases in courts, for reducing the overcrowding of prisons, and for increasing the effectiveness of police and courts. These discussions are in the framework of support from the governments of Germany and the UK. We are delighted that officials from the two ministries, prison officers, police, judges, lawyers, legal aid officers, local government members, journalists, development practitioners from local and national level, academics and restorative justice practitioners from home and abroad will discuss how restorative justice can reduce crime, restore faith in the delivery of justice, give voice and closure to victims, remove fear of crime, and explore the potential of this approach in Bangladesh. We are very, very pleased to have amongst us a significant number of visitors from abroad, but I have to mention two names, Professor John Braithwaite, and he is known as the father of restorative justice. Many of us who have been students of criminologists have read his books, and Honorable Judge Sean Lyons from the Wood Green Courts. You will hear them speak throughout the next 2 days. Many of you are already aware that this conference is organized by the Ministry of Home Affairs and the General Technical Cooperation under the Project Improvement of the Real Situation of Overcrowding in Prisons, the Institute of Social Welfare and Research, Dhaka University, is co-hosting this conference. The project is supported by the German Federal Ministry of Economic Cooperation and Development, PMZ, and by the UK Department for International Development, BFID, and implemented by GISN. We will now welcome our honored guest to the inaugural session. In no particular order of protocol, I will request the chair of the session, Mr. Mohammed Muzammil Haq Khan, Senior Secretary, Ministry of Home Affairs, the Honorable Speaker of Bangladesh Parliament, Dr. Shinjamin Chaudhry, our special guest, Mr. Asad Zaman Khan, MP, Honorable Minister of Home Affairs, our guest of honor, Dr. Bonaya, the Charge of Affairs of the German Embassy, Ms. Sarah Cook, Country Representative of Defense, and Mr. Tobias Fair to the podium. I would kindly request all of you to join us here at the podium. This marks the official beginning of our inaugural session, and I am very, very pleased to invite our guest of honor, Mr. Tobias Fair, Country Director of GIZ, for his few words.
Speaker of the Bangladesh Parliament, Dr. Shireen Shamim Chaudhry, MP, distinguished special guest, Mr. Asad Zaman Khan, Honorable Minister of the Ministry of Home Affairs,
আমাদের এই বিশ্বাসের কারণে আমরা বিভিন্ন সেবাদানমূলক চুক্তি হতে পেরেছে বাংলাদেশ সরকারের সাথে এবং এনজিওগুলোর মাধ্যমে, এবং বিভিন্ন দেশে এই অংশীদারিত্ব সম্ভব না বিভিন্ন নিরাপত্তা এবং অপকার প্রতিরোধের জন্য। আমাদের এই কোঅপারেশন কখনোই সম্ভব হতো না যদি না বাংলাদেশের যে বিভিন্ন অংশীদার মন্ত্রণালয়গুলো আছে তারা আমাদের উপর বিশ্বাস না রাখে, এবং আজকে প্যানেলে যারা উপস্থিত আছেন তাদের নেতৃত্ব এবং দৃষ্টিভঙ্গির কারণে আজকে সবকিছু সম্ভব হয়েছে। আমি অত্যন্ত গর্বিত আজকের ক্লোজিং আমাদের ওপেনিং সেশনে সবাইকে আমন্ত্রণ জানাতে পেরে, এবং আপনাদেরকে আমি অত্যন্ত ধন্যবাদ জানাতে চাই আপনাদের বিশ্বাসের জন্য ডিআইসির প্রতি। আমি বিশেষভাবে ধন্যবাদ জানাতে চাই আমার কলিগদেরকে যারা অত্যন্ত হার্ড ওয়ার্ক করেছেন তাদের ডেডিকেশনের জন্য, এবং আমি শেষ করতে চাই আমার বক্তব্য আমার বিভিন্ন
Trust, which is doing through our community legal
community legal service project. It was very inspiring. A few weeks ago, I went to see it. It was very inspiring. It was community legal services and the community legal services and the communities of legal rights, often at risk of their own personal safety.
Secretary, academicians, professors, judges, guests from abroad and from all over Bangladesh alike, a very good morning to all of you. I'm very happy to be here this morning.
Good morning, Yelensky.
Let me start by saying congratulations. It's already impressive the number of people who've come together and it's a wonderful cooperation between the Ministry of Home Affairs, the Dhaka University, and the German Development Cooperation Agency, GIZ. Ladies and gentlemen, the reform in criminal justice process is a priority of the Bangladesh-German cooperation.
Towards
Germany and precisely to our agency GIZ, which has been working for now many years since 2008 on a very sensitive issue. Because criminal cases, law enforcement, this is something which goes in the heart of every country. So let me start off by saying thank you. Thank you for this trust. Thank you for this cooperation with Germany. And this thank you goes to all the agencies, the police, the ministries, the judges, the paralegals, the NGOs, all those
the number of re-offenders
Thank you.
প্রিজনারদেরকে শুধুমাত্র কারাগারে
between the two ministries in encouraging and ensuring the safeguard of the citizens of this country. Now, with the greatest of pleasure, I invite Dr. Shirin Sharmin Chaudhary, MP, the Honourable Speaker of the Bangladesh Government, to the podium for her speech.
Honourable Chair, Dr. Mohammad Ghazamil Khan, Senior Secretary, Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of the People's Republic of Bangladesh. Honourable Special Guest, Mr. Asadu Saman Khan, MP, Honourable Minister, Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of the People's Republic of Bangladesh. Honourable Guests of Honour, Distinguished Guests, Participants, Media Representatives, Ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning to you all. It is a great pleasure for me, and I'm delighted to be here this morning at the International Conference on Restorative Justice, from Crime Prevention to Conflict Transformation. This conference has been organized through a partnership between the Government of Bangladesh, Germany, and the United Kingdom. I thank them all for their continued support to the Government of Bangladesh. I would also like to thank the Ministry of Home Affairs, GIZ, and the German Federal Ministry for Economic Cooperation and Development, the UK Department for International Development, DFID, and the Institute of Social Welfare and Research, Dhaka University, who have also taken part in organizing this International Conference on Restorative Justice. I have to admit that this is a new initiative in Bangladesh. I'm happy to learn that resource persons from the international arena with a wealth full of knowledge on restorative justice are here with us in this initiative, and I greatly support their contribution and the way they are introducing the concept of restorative justice in Bangladesh. It will be extremely useful for all of us, and we will benefit immensely to learn about the concept of restorative justice from them. We need to learn more about this issue, as we are not too familiar with it. But I am told that through this project initiative, the work that is ongoing in Bangladesh and in different parts of Bangladesh is going on very successfully, and the practical application of the concept with inclusion of all the different stakeholders and particularly at the grassroots community level has been a big success, and I hope that this success continues throughout in making restorative justice a success in Bangladesh also. The Constitution of Bangladesh in 1972, it was adopted, and this constitution is actually the main source of all the fundamental human rights that are guaranteed there. Access to justice is one of the most basic human rights. It is inextricably linked. The upholding of access to justice and ensuring this fundamental human right is very closely linked and has a special nexus with upholding the rule of law and good governance. The criminal justice system in Bangladesh is there, and we are introducing different kinds of reforms to make it more effective at different points of time. The government has undergone many initiatives to bring about effective changes in the criminal justice system. There are many issues which need to be addressed while we talk about reforming the criminal justice system. It is important to deal with the backlog of the cases, delay in dispensing justice, making it more cost-effective, strengthening the legal aid initiatives, and support for the poor to have better access, and to remove the social barriers and challenges which sometimes cause hindrance to victims to take the shelter of the law. There's a number of legislation on different issues which is a wide coverage for the people to come and take refuge of the law in cases of any kind of violation. But it is important to facilitate the process in the criminal justice system to allow the victims to come forward and take the refuge of law. The practice of restorative justice is widespread in many parts of the world, and we know that there is compelling evidence to show how the restorative justice approach is being practiced with success. For example, by the police and the judiciary in the UK, social reintegration for prisoners in Hungary, for peace building in Mindanao, Philippines, and in correctional centers in Canada, and many more. So we would also like to see that this concept is implemented with success in our country, but I also feel that on the one hand, it is important to make the stakeholders, which is a wide range of stakeholders who are involved, if we want to make it a success, that we include them, we make them more aware, and give them a better understanding of what is required out of them, and how they can all facilitate and incorporate in making this a success. And at the same time, when we are talking about the experience of different countries of the world in promoting restorative justice and how it has helped to reduce the problems that it wanted to address, it is important to take the socio-economic context of each country and also that of Bangladesh. Experience shows that it is a highly effective means to bring harmony back into the community after harm has been caused, whether to an individual or to a group of people. I see from the background of the experts at this conference that restorative justice as an approach is being practiced with success elsewhere. It is indeed an honor and pleasure that we have the world-renowned experts with us to help us take this initiative forward. I believe that there is an opportunity to look at the practice of restorative justice more widely in Bangladesh. The government of Bangladesh is working to bring about different changes in the criminal justice system for effective implementation of the laws and to vindicate the right of the victims. And it is looking at ways to address some of the problems that exist in the delivery of justice to the people. And I hope that this restorative justice concept will have a lasting impact in bringing about and minimizing the differences that exist between the victim and the offender, and also to rehabilitate the offenders, to bring reinforce the people's confidence in the criminal justice system. The government is open to ideas to deal with issues affecting the criminal justice system and thereby hastening the process of justice delivery. I would like to see that there are concrete suggestions which are implemented, and I believe that one initiative is also being undertaken in Rangpur, which is the northern part of Bangladesh, and it has shown huge success. I hope we can share this success in other parts of Bangladesh also, and I hope that the restorative justice concept will pave the way for social harmony and peace in the society in Bangladesh also. I wish this conference a huge success, and I wish that through the participation of all concerned, we will be able to derive benefit from restorative justice concept in our criminal justice delivery system also. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.